Come on in. Hello.
Hello.
I'm loving your suit.
Thank you. Me too.
Someone is ready for 73 questions. Are you ready to get started?
Can't do it without a rainbow bow tie.
Absolutely. All right. How are you today?
I'm good. Working on myself, but feeling really great in this suit. More girls in suits.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Where are you from?
Northern New Jersey. Why did that take so long?
Is your real name Jessie Paege?
Technically, my real name is actually Jessica Paege Eisenberg, but as you can tell by the suit, Jessica didn't really fit my vibe.
What made you start YouTube?
I started YouTube because I was incredibly shy and suffered from something called, it's called selective mutism and also social anxiety, and it was a really good way to find a voice.
Who inspired you to make videos?
Ooh, Connor Franta, Troy Sivan, Bethany Moda, so many people.
What was the first video you remember thinking that this could be a career for you?
I made a video called I'm 17 and it's time for the truth. And it was probably the first time I was honest on camera. I'd kind of stuck to doing makeup videos and tutorials because I thought that was what girls had to do. And I loved how it impacted people.
I remember that video.
Here we are now.
Were you ever nervous in front of the camera?
Yes. Well, first video, it's like an outfits video, and technically all you can see is my butt because my friend was really short that was filming it, and like, yeah.
Who was the first person you told about your videos?
My friend that filmed the video.
How did people react when you first started telling people?
They were not very nice, and never to my face, which probably hurt me even more.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Why did you move to LA?
Because I wanted to pursue this.
What were some of your childhood dreams outside of being a YouTuber?
Ooh, I wanted to get into nutrition because my mom had cancer multiple times growing up.
At what age did you pick up the guitar?
I picked up the guitar age 10. My dad taught me, and now I'm teaching him. Love you.
I love that. I love the records on your wall, too.
Thank you.
Acoustic or electric?
Electric. Love my alternative music.
What's your favorite song to play on guitar?
Hotel California by the Eagles. Anything by Queen. Anything by the Black Keys or Reapers by Muse.
Could you play a little bit for us now?
I'm still getting used to playing for other people, but this is gonna make it seem like I totally have this plug planned. Promise I didn't. I have an Instagram called Jessie's Tunes where your girl's gonna be posting some covers, hopefully.
I'll be sure to check it out. If you could play in any band, what would it be?
I would play for Brendan Urie, but I don't think I'm worthy.
No, we hear you're a great musician.
Thank you.
What made you start making mental health videos and LGBTQ+ videos?
It's the most relevant thing in my life, and seeing how it affected other people, I do it with the intention of what I would have wanted to hear growing up.
At what age did you realize you're on the spectrum?
I remember having a weird fascination with goth girl cartoon characters growing up.
Oops. That's hilarious. How did the internet help you?
I met so many amazing LGBT creators that helped me with my coming out video.
If you could give someone advice in 3 words, what would it be?
Happiness comes first.
I love that.
Thank you.
You're so expressive. When did you first decide to dye your hair?
I first dyed my hair when I was 16.
Wow. Would you ever go back to your original color?
Yes, because I miss people saying I look like Miley Cyrus.
I definitely see that.
No, not anymore. I wish.
What's your favorite Instagram photo you've ever posted?
So this year I've really taken to using my Instagram to kind of reflect my YouTube channel more and portray more mental health related messages and more of my personality and so on. And I have this photo, and it was my concept, and it's me holding physical health and mental health, and it kind of just shows that life is a balance between the two.
That's awesome. How many Instagram accounts do you have?
Too many.
What would you name your kids?
I love the name Star.
Aw, that's so cute.
Yeah.
What's next for Jessica Eisenberg?
Ooh, hopefully some mental health related short films and just continuing to creatively challenge myself.
Do you date?
I don't date and tell.
Ooh, well, if you did, what would be your dream date?
Driving around and listening to music.
Would you date a fan?
I wouldn't not date a fan.
What's the craziest experience you've ever had with someone who watches your video?
Mom's like crying meet and greets. Uh-huh. It's so cute.
We hear you were once a fan. Can you tell us more?
I love supporting other YouTubers, just genuinely. I still watch their videos. I buy their merch. I just think we're all in this together.
I love that. Who was the first person that you looked up to that started watching videos of yours?
I remember Bethany Moda following me on Instagram, and I cried.
Speaking of internet friends, how did you meet Crank That Frank?
I DM'd him, and he's like, she seems emo enough, let's collab.
Who are some of your other internet friends?
Casually holds up merch. I would say, ooh, I have so many, they know who they are.
Is it true that Frank knows every song to, or every lyric to every Panic at the Disco song?
Sorry, I walk fast. yes.
Is it true that you guys were once in a garage band together in Jersey?
No, that sounds so cool! we do a lot of karaoke nights though, and we both are from New Jersey.
Well, is it true that you guys are the new voices of Ratatouille 2?
Might have signed a contract where we can't talk about things. All I'll say is, we are rats for Ratatouille.
We hear you're a big fan of Disney, is that true?
Yeah.
Love that. Who doesn't love Disney?
Mm-hmm.
Who would you say is your YouTube family?
My people that watch my videos.
Do you have any siblings?
I have a younger brother, and he had social media for a week, and I have no idea what he does now. All he does is text me anime recommendations.
So siblings are four.
Exactly.
Favorite video game?
Super Smash Brothers.
Love it. So tell us about this rumor that you script your videos. Is that true?
No, though I probably should script them. So thanks for the advice.
You're doing great here.
Do that. Thanks.
What's your biggest insecurity?
My laugh. I always got made fun of for it growing up, but like now I've really been a lot more comfortable with myself.
I love your laugh.
Thank you.
What is a mental health stigma you really want to break?
That teenagers don't suffer from mental illness. I think mental illness is not related to age.
What's the biggest thing related to mental health you learned this year?
It's never going to be perfect, and that's okay.
I need to live by that.
Yeah.
All right, speed round. Are you ready?
Yeah, let's go for it.
All right, favorite time of year?
Summer. Why was I going to say winter?
Favorite artist?
I don't know.
Song?
Live in the Moment by Portugal the Man.
Color?
Pink.
Movie?
Big Hero 6.
TV show?
Steven Universe.
City.
Portland.
Morning versus night.
Morning.
Warm versus cold.
Warm.
Coffee versus tea.
Coffee.
What is the tea?
I go to sleep at 10 p.m. and that's about all the drama in my life.
What's your dream collab?
Billie Eilish. Ooh. But I think I'd fangirl too much, / not be worthy, / a lot of other things.
Oh, I love that answer.
Thank
What's
you.
Your sign?
Pisces, but rising Aries, and my moon is Capricorn.
Fascinating, isn't it?
Yes.
Would you say you're accurate to your sign?
Yes, very sensitive.
If you had to pick one thing you couldn't live without, what would it be?
YouTube.
What's your favorite thing about LA?
Meeting all the creative people out here.
Where are you headed to next?
To see my family for the holidays. Aww. Yeah.
Speaking of beach towns, are you bringing the mermaid branding back?
It never left.
What about the dad branding?
Never left either. I'm wearing a suit.
Why do you call your viewers your people? Love the ears.
Thank you. Had to. We talked about Disney.
Absolutely.
I call them my people because they're the people that fully understand me.
Everyone needs people in their life.
Yeah.
I hear you're an author too. What was that like?
It was absolutely insanely surreal to be able to write something to introduce these younger kids to mental health related topics.
Did you ever expect to write a book?
No.
What are you looking forward to in 2019?
More serious content, as well as creatively challenging myself, and hopefully new hair colors. Actually, no, shouldn't do that again.
We're all ready. What's something you're leaving in 2018?
Being closeted.
All right, three more questions. Are you ready?
Yeah.
How many tables did you break this year?
Too many. Sorry, IKEA.
Who is glam with Jessie?
An icon.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. All right, last question. Why do you create content?
I create content because I want to tell people what I wish I heard growing up, and I hope that I give some type of voice to the voiceless, and I want my community to be a place where everyone feels safe, no matter what their identity or state of, you know, any type of state of being is, and I hope it also allows for people to explore mental health more as well.
Using your platform for good. I love it. Well, thank you, Jessie Paege. Thank you, Jessica Eisenberg. Thank you, Glam with Jessie.
Thank you.
We hope to hear a lot more music and see a lot more from you this year.
We'll see.
Thank you.